Russia is testing their new secret jet fighter. The race for having complete and total dominance of the skies is being contested by three major superpowers of the world: the US, Russia, and China. With each nation looking to beat the other, major technological strides are being made in the aerospace industry. With the advent of sixth-generation stealth fighter jets, the fifth-generation planes are already considered to be obsolete. The major point of contention and competition between these three superpowers is who will develop the best sixth-generation stealth fighter jet. Russia has been developing its stealth fighter jets for quite some time now. The Sukhoi Su-57 was first announced back in 2002. Since then, it has faced many delays and problems, but the program has persevered, and the stealth fighter is reportedly near completion. The first maiden flight for the Su-57 was back in 2011, and it will be ready to officially join the arsenal of the Russian Air Force in the next year. It is intended to replace the fourth-generation MiG-29s and Su-27s in the Russian Air Force. If the reports surfacing about the capabilities of the Su-57 are to be believed, then it will surely be a worthy contender to take on the F-35s and F-22s, which currently makes the US the undisputed king of aerial combat and reconnaissance. Why is the Su-57 a threat to the F-22 and F-35? The Su-57 is, by all means, a formidable stealth fighter jet. According to reports, it will be powered by two AL-41F1 high-performance engines. One of the major problems that this aircraft faced in its development phase was the engine. The amount of time and effort that was put in by Russian engineers to solve this issue has definitively paid off, as the AL-41F1 has proven to be competent and reliable. The frame of the Su-57 is based on the experimental T-50 prototypes, which means that the Su-57 has the full range of stealth capabilities. The AL-41F1 engines are a variant of the 117S, which also indicates that they will be stealth compatible. The plan seems to be that once the Su-57 enters service, further research and development will be put into the engine, and it will eventually be upgraded to give the Su-57 improved capabilities of range, flight altitude, and supercruise speed. The new version will also give the plane a 40,000-pound thrust that will be an upgrade from the existing engine, meaning that the agility of the plane will be greatly enhanced. The plane will be capable of reaching Mach 2 and will be able to cruise at 1,120 miles per hour. To accommodate these extreme speeds, the airframe is capable of handling up to 9 Gs of force. The core component of the Su-57 is its stealth capability, and it does not disappoint. It incorporates both radar-absorbing materials and onboard counter systems. The frame of the aircraft is also specifically designed to minimize its radar signature. The engines can reach supersonic speeds without leaving behind a significant afterburner, which can be easily picked up by radars. The reconnaissance capabilities are no joke as well. The Advanced Active Phase Radar Array (APRA) system will be equipped in the plane to give it both side-scanning and forward-looking abilities. The Su-57 will have the ability to track and engage multiple targets simultaneously due to its advanced radar system. It will have the ability to open fire on both ground-based and air-based targets. The cockpit of the Su-57 is designed in a way that gives the pilot maximum visibility and the ability to read all the digital inputs from its various sensors easily. The firepower capability of the Su-57 is also very impressive. Although it is shrouded in secrecy, some rumors indicate that specialized weapons that will be for use exclusively by the Su-57 are in development. What we know for sure is that the stealth fighter jet will feature two 30mm GSH-301 series cannons. The plane will have 6 internal and external hardpoints. The aircraft will support the extensive arsenal of missiles that the Russian military possesses, such as the KH-35E, which is an anti-ship missile, the R-77RVVMD, which is an air-to-surface missile, the KH-58U Shaki, which is an anti-radiation missile, and the KH-38ME, which is another air-to-surface missile. In the early years of its service, the Su-57 will likely be outfitted with existing missile technology until the rumored specialized weapons are produced. Unmanned flight mode. Has Russia done it? The future of combat is leaning towards unmanned aircraft. The success that the US has had on the modern-day battlefield with drones is undeniable, and other superpowers of the world are also gravitating towards the idea of drones and unmanned aircraft. There are quite a few significant advantages of having unmanned machines fight for you. The obvious benefit is that countless lives can be saved through this. The second advantage is that unmanned aircraft will push the envelope of what we consider possible and normal. When a pilot is flying a fighter jet, the maneuvers and situations that the plane can handle are limited by the capabilities of the pilot. One huge factor is the physical limitations of the conditions that the human body can handle under stress and extraordinary G-force. When we eliminate this factor of human limitation, suddenly anything is possible. If this turns out to be true, then the scope of what can be achieved with these fighter jets will expand exponentially. These aircraft will be able to do what is not humanly possible. They will be able to move and engage targets with precision and perform reconnaissance missions that were previously impossible and without putting any friendly lives at risk. If Russia succeeds in this effort of creating planes that are piloted remotely and use AI, then it will give them a significant advantage over the competition. First reported by a Chinese news agency, Sukhoi, the Su-57 apparently has the ability of unmanned flight and AI combat. If these reports are to be believed, then Russia has made a major breakthrough in the world of aerial combat. To better understand the implications of this technology, if the plane is being piloted remotely, it will be able to withstand 15 Gs of force, which is unprecedented. It will allow the plane to move with greater agility and allow it to perform maneuvers that are not possible with a human pilot inside because of the impact of G-force. Speculations are that Russia is working towards developing a whole army of autonomous machines. The idea here is to replace soldiers and pilots with these machines. It might sound like a far-fetched idea, but if reports are to be believed, then it might be closer to reality than we think. Last year, Russia developed its first strike drone by the name of S-70. It also intended to be used in conjunction with the Su-57. If this stealth fighter manages to fly unmanned and has the ability to control the S-70 drones with the help of AI during flight, it will create a deadly and fearsome combo. The idea is that while the Su-57 deals with targets in the sky, the Su-70 drones will be used to clear out any threats on the ground. There are reports of autonomous robots that the Russian military has created are already capable of taking the battlefield if needed. The Fedor is an example of Russia's plan to create an army of robots. In addition to robots, the Russian army is also developing unmanned tanks. A smaller unmanned vehicle, Narekta, is already in active service for the Russian military. It has three modes of transport, surveillance, and combat, meaning it can do a variety of missions without putting any friendly lives at risk. The Uran 9 and Uran 6 are other examples of unmanned vehicles that Russia has developed. Both of these vehicles are battlefield support vehicles that are capable of destroying military outposts and tanks. The Vicar is an autonomous tank that the Russian military has developed. It is mainly a reconnaissance vehicle, but has enough firepower to take on tanks and even aerial targets. It is also amphibious, meaning that it can perform on all sorts of terrains without any problems. The Su-57 has a lot of promise, and with the ability of autonomous flight being touted, it just might help Russia take the crown of the skies from the US. The advancement that is being made in the field of stealth fighter jets is revolutionary, and it's all thanks to healthy competition. We will have to wait and see if all these rumors about the Su-57's abilities turn out to be true or not. One thing is for sure, with all the superpowers of the world in a heated race to have the best stealth aircraft, we will see some truly stunning pieces of engineering in the coming years. The incorporation of AI in combat will play a huge part in who ends up coming out on top.